everyone, we are back today to discuss about the playing conditions. We had promised you guys that we will be discussing about the playing conditions all, differently. So today's playing conditions, the ones that we will be discussing, are the third umpire will automatically review any call of a short run by the on-field umpire. Before reviewing an LBW decision, the batter or fielding captain can confirm with the on-field umpire whether an attempt has been made to play the ball. And the third one is for LBW reviews. The height margin of the wicket zone has been lifted to the top of the stumps. So for short run, obviously, it's a fair call. Because short run, we have seen in IPL, Punjab was actually, Punjab lost a match. Was it lost a match? I think they lost a match, right?
Yeah, by one run. Yeah,
by one run because of that short run call, which was actually not a short run. So they have, rectified. For the LBW decision, I think it has got a lot to do with that whole Joe Root controversy that had happened. A little bit of controversy.
Correct.
But also, before proceeding to the third one, I would like to ask you to actually tell us that what do you mean by whether an attempt has been made to play the ball? How can you define the attempt?
Correct. So, I have to get up from my chair and I have to give a little demo.
You have to get up from your chair.
So, for example, if this is the stump,
yes,
to know whether you have played, intentionally you have played the ball or not, for the viewers, you first have to know the LBW rule. I know everybody, a lot of people know it, but I still revisit that rule. For example, if I am a right-hand batter, I am batting like this, anything which pitches outside my off stump, hits me in the line and goes on to hit the stump, I am out.
Correct.
If this happens, if anything pitches outside the leg stump, outside my leg stump, see this is the stump line, the wicket line. See this is the wicket, this is the line. If anything pitches outside of this, okay, outside my leg stump, no matter what happens after that, it will be not out. Now there is a scenario where if a ball pitches outside my off stump, doesn't hit me in the line, hits me outside of my off stump. For example, this is my off stump line and it hits me outside. My leg is outside. It hits me outside, goes on to hit the stumps. It can still be out if I am not trying to play the ball. So how am I not trying to play the ball? If I shoulder arms like this, I am intentionally not trying to play the ball. That is very, very obvious that I am not trying to play the ball. So the ball is pitching outside of stump, goes on to hit me in my leg, which is again outside my off stump line, but goes on to hit my stumps, and I am trying to shoulder arms and not trying to intentionally play the ball. Now, what needs to happen is that this is clearly obvious that I was not trying to play the ball. What some batter used to do is the ball pitching outside of stump, they used to just plunk their leg forward and what they used to do with their bat, behind the pad, they would first plunk their foot forward and then just move the bat just behind the leg. Maybe intentionally they used to do that to get away with it. Maybe they didn't want to play the shot, but by putting the bat just beside or behind the pad, they used to confuse umpire and opposition captains that they are trying to play a shot. Because see, if you are doing like this, it is clearly obvious that you are not trying to play a shot. But when you do something like this, you don't know whether the batter is trying to play a shot or not trying to play a shot. Because when the ball hits his leg or her leg for that matter, his or her back is not in front of the pad, it's behind the pad. But what happens just after the ball strikes the pad, what he or she does like this, just fakes a shot. So umpire has to decide whether the shot was played intentionally or unintentionally, like whether there was deliberate padding or not. Now, for example, if the umpire thought that it was not deliberate padding, the shot was intentionally played, because it depends from umpire to umpire. He judges it within those seconds before doing the decision. Now, he thinks, for example, the umpire thinks that, okay, that is deliberate, not deliberate padding. He tried, he or she tried to play this one. But the captain doesn't know that. The opposition captain, they appeal, they used to go to the third umpire, and then it was learned. Yeah, in the referral, when it was, so the captain is thinking, okay, the batter has not offered a shot, and now I'll get him out. Because if you don't offer a shot and it hits like that, you are out. But the umpire in his mind has decided that, okay, no, he or she has tried to play the shot, and thus he or she is not given out. But now what will happen? In situations like this, the umpire has to tell the captain that whether he thinks in a situation like this that the batter has or has not tried to play a shot. Well, and then only then the captain will decide whether he wants to review it or not review it. In that sense, what will happen if he thinks, if the umpire clearly says that, okay, this batter has tried to play a shot, he will not go for a review. He will not waste his review or her review. That's a simple, that's a very, very good change in the rule.
Absolutely, and well explained. But Orko, I just wanted to see your bat. Can you show me your bat once, please? And I want to know what is this? What is the sponsor sticker in the bat? With this bat, every single ball.
I will not reveal the sponsor details.
Right. So you know, I think it's a very good rule. Very good change in rule. Let's go to the third one then. The third one is LBW reviews, the height margin of the wicket zone has been lifted to the top of the stumps. Although I would like to explain it in two ways.
Correct.
First of all, what is a wicket zone?
That you can do it in full frame. Correct.
So, what is a wicket zone? Suppose, okay, this is not stumps. This is, we can't get stumps here. But suppose the white part of the cup is wicket, and let's consider the silver part as your as the bell. Okay, if this part is the bell and this part is the stump, the white part is the stump, the silver part is the bell, the wicket zone till date was considered to be up to this point where the bells are starting, that point. Now it will be considered till here. Now I will explain it in a very layman term. Up till now, when 50% of the ball was hitting up to this area, see, this is more than 50%. And the beginning of it's just where the bells are placed. That was known as the wicket zone. And if in this case you're out, in this case you're not out. Again, I'm repeating, in this case you were out, in this case you were not out. Now, with the current change in rule, the position that I have put the ball in, it's out.
Correct.
So, see, 50%, more than 50% of the ball is, has hit the stump, so it's out.
Correct.
Again, I'm repeating, till date, this was out. The moment this happened, it was not out. Now, this is out as well. So the bowlers, what it eventually does is, there will be bounce for the bowlers in England, right or go? So when there is bounce, these LBWs, the bowlers used to miss because of the height. Now this has changed because of this rule and a fantastic change in rules. Awesome change in rules, because everything cannot be about batters. And that's why this change in rule will actually help the bowlers. Both the rules, the one that you explained, the one that I explained. Should I show once more, you know? Once more, the wicket zone till date was, the wicket zone till date was only the white portion till the bell started. Considering the white portion is stumps and the silver portion is the bells, right? So up to this was out. The moment this happened, it became not out. Now, this is out, as well as this is out. So, it's a very good change in rule. And do you think, Orko, this makes the World Test Championship final way more interesting? And should they continue this, like retain this rule for, you know,
Definitely. That brings balance to the game, because the fielding side as well as the bowlers now are in a better position in terms of taking wickets, and also the captains won't look like fools because regarding that batter playing a shot or not playing a shot, at times they were captain used to be sure that the batter has not played a shot, whether the umpire was on a different pace because umpire used to think that he has played a shot, and on that basis there was a bit of miscommunication between the two set of parties. But now that will not happen. There will be a proper consultation, and then only they will go up to the third umpire. So it's clean, crystal clean, no ambiguity in it.
Absolutely, it's crystal clean. That the rules are crystal clean. They are less confusing. But there is one thing I'm absolutely confused about. You know, why are people not subscribing to our channel?
Okay, I will explain them in a better way.
Yes, please.
People, before COVID, you all used to go to restaurants or restaurant, some people say.
Yeah.
Okay. And then when you used to like the food, what did you used to do? You all used to take your friends to that place.
Correct.
Note down the address. Note down if it used to deliver, you note down the phone numbers. Order it on the different sites, Swiggy, Zomato. Okay, by the way, Swiggy, Zomato is not paying us. So, you used to keep a track of the restaurant. You used to refer to each and every one that, okay, go to this restaurant. If you like the food, I am guaranteeing that you will like the food. Now, if you like our videos, why won't you give the same kind of treatment to us? Humne kya galti kiya? Like our videos, share it with your friends, and definitely subscribe our YouTube channel. नहीं तो पता कैसे चलेगा कि नया क्या food मतलब खाना या मतलब content कैसे नया आ रहा है?
आ रहा है correct. Subscribe to our channel, follow us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram. You can follow Orgho and me on Instagram as well as Twitter, and keep coming and discussing, different things with us. Tomorrow, by the way, Orgho, I will be, both of us will be discussing something very interesting. Why has been the grade one Duke's ball exactly specified? Right? And that is something very interesting that I will explain for you guys. So please do join us. As of now, stay home, stay safe, take care, and bye-bye.